Hi, my name is Sinead Burke and I am a PhD candidate in the School of Education in Trinity College Dublin. I'm researching the role of student voice in Irish primary school classrooms, but simultaneously I'm a primary school teacher. I qualified almost 5 or 6 years ago now, which is a little bit scary, but I really miss and love being in the classroom. Teaching college was the most amazing experience. From the age of 4, I knew that I wanted to be a primary school teacher. I think on my second day of junior infants, I told everybody in my school, from my principal to my class teacher to every child in my class. And it was amazing. I had one choice on my CAO form. I knew exactly the college of education that I wanted to go to and the course that I wanted to do. And looking back now, it's really empowering and fulfilling that that happened. As for regards to one particular memory that I loved, I guess it was probably on teaching practice, which is the most stressful time for any student. I had junior infants, I was being assessed, there was a supervisor down the back of the room. I think I was doing something simple like an English or language lesson. One child put up her hand in front of the supervisor and said, "Little teacher, little teacher." Of course, panic ensued. And I took a step back and I said, how will I react to this? Will I use my teacher voice and my teacher stare and reprimand the child? Or will I do something different? So I walked down to her and I said, are you looking for me? She looked at me like I was the most stupid person on the entire planet. And she said, yeah. I said, what's my name? She said, little teacher? I said, no, it's Miss Burke. She said, okay, I'm stuck. What page are we on? I said, it's page 4. She said, okay, thanks, bye. And I realized then in that moment, what amazing an opportunity and a privilege it is to work with children, because in a way they don't see difference like us adults. They see us as a vehicle and as a way to help them get their education. And it's a really fortunate and lucky position to be in every day. I think that's my favourite memory. I keep connected with my classmates and the people I went to college with, those before and after I graduated, through social media, really. It would be lovely if there was a platform that existed solely just for the purpose of connecting with previous students. But at the moment, that doesn't exist, at least not for me. But it's lovely to see people's photographs and updates on social media, whether that they've just got dipped and the inspector has been in and they've passed, or they're struggling and want to plan a lesson but don't have the resources correctly, or are struggling with the scheme. And it's really, really uplifting and really encouraging that community exists online and in real life. You know, you can ring them, you can text them, and regardless if you haven't seen them in 5 years, 10 years, or 2 weeks, I think teachers will always be really supportive of one another, regardless of how long it's been. Lifelong learning is essential for any career, but I think particularly within education and within teaching. Curriculum changes, but more importantly, so do the children in front of you. They move along with technology at a much greater pace than us adults. They use Snapchat from probably the age of 10 to 11. And I think it's important that as adults and as teachers, that we really invest in the students who are in front of us. We really invest in the things that they are interested in, that they learn about and from outside of the classroom, and bring it into the classroom. So whether that's updating your knowledge and skills of various new technologies and mediums that you can bring into the classroom, or knowing who won the match yesterday, or about the European qualifiers, so that you can go in and, you know, encourage those who are interested in those kind of mediums. I think it's essential. We need to continuously update our skills and don't become complacent in what we have or what we graduated with years and years ago. It sounds quite cliche, but in terms of three words that would really describe teaching: vocation, privilege, and maybe slightly misunderstood. I think there's this concept as to what teaching is from the outside community. You know, you do it from 9 until 20 to 3 and you have a long holiday, which are true. But there's also huge responsibility, because not only are you teaching children the curriculum and giving them skills that they will have for their entire life, but you are fundamental to their holistic development. You have an imprint and an impact on thousands of young people. You change who they are, inevitably, by the way in which you engage with them, or unfortunately, disengage with them. And I know so many people who are in the careers that they are in now and doing things with their life because of the impact a teacher had on them when they were 4, 12, 18. And I think we need to appreciate that a bit more, both those of us who are teachers and those of us who aren't. What's next for me? That's an open-ended question. And I'm really fortunate that I'm in the position that I don't yet know what the answer is. You know, you look at something like Twitter, which is a massive entity now in 2016. It didn't exist 10 years ago. And I think we're in a really lovely, confusing strange and interesting time where there's lots of opportunities arising in relation to education. So perhaps I'll get involved in policy construction or doing unconscious bias training in regard to the lack of diversity that's currently within the primary school education system here in Ireland. But I don't know. I'm very fortunate to be 2 years left of my PhD. We'll see what happens.